And they say money can't buy happiness, but we'll show you six reasons why they may be wrong. Coming up now.
From NBC News, this is Today's Take.
Plus, the six ways money can buy happiness.
Not via pads.
That's right after this. This is good. You know the saying, money can't buy happiness. According to a recent study, though, that's not true.
Yeah, there are certain items that you can buy that can actually improve your mood and well-being. And here to tell us about them is Director of Landmark Research, which did the survey, Randall Bell, and psychologist Elizabeth Lombardo. Hey, guys, how are you?
Great. Good morning.
So, Dr. Bell, you say that money can actually help you in some ways, that some small purchases can make you happy.
Well, money does buy happiness, but the good news is that happiness is not expensive. We did research. We surveyed 5,000 people around the world, and we reconciled it to four habits. Me habits improve our mindset. We habits improve our relationships with others. Okay. Do habits improve productivity, and B habits improve going forward in the future.
Oh, okay. I like that. Okay.
So let's dig in. Give us bits of happiness. Again, it doesn't have to cost a lot.
It's not expensive.
Yeah, and the research backs this up.
If you do just a little bit of work and remember people's birthdays, you have a 14.1% more likely chance of being happy.
Wow, what? 14% yeah. higher.
Is that because you're making other people happy, so then it makes you happy?
You got it.
So we're social beings, right? And close relationships bring us greater happiness. Mm-hmm. It goes way beyond a like on social media. When you write a card, a heartfelt card, you share it, it helps you feel closer, which brings us greater happiness.
I love handwritten letters. I look back at some of the love letters that my husband
Let's send somebody a card.
This makes me happy. Sleep. And you say a pillow. Invest in a pillow, right?
A pillow is something as simple as a pillow. If you get a good night's sleep, you're 25.2% more likely to be happy. And also better romance, better education, better wealth and income.
Better romance.
So now this is for a lot of people. This is a good one. Tickets to the big game. We all know sports can make people happy, but what is it specifically about this?
Well, this statistic kind of surprised me. You're 208% more likely to be happy if you're into sports. I'm not into sports, really? But I've got to rethink it myself.
Well, and here's the thing. Our mood is impacted by our focus. And so often we're focused on the future, worrying about what might happen, or the past, regretting about it. We want to be present. That brings us more happiness. When you're at a sporting event, you tend to be present and focused on what's going on.
I love that, actually. And I think also we should think about that number, 208%. That's high.
Yeah. Double. Yeah. Over double.
Especially if your team is winning. Don't even get me started when your team's not winning. All right, what do you have next?
Even if they're losing, you're part
of
something.
You're part of a team.
Right?
Or you're part of a community.
You have that connection
collection
again.
That's
all right.
Great.
Magazines?
Yeah, magazines.
Reading correlates with happiness, and staying away from gossip correlates with unhappiness. So my advice is, if you're prone to gossip, you know, maybe read a tabloid, but better off don't gossip at all, and instead put your energy into reading.
It's something positive, something that's meaningful to you. Maybe it's a biography about someone who inspires you.
Yeah, I'm a reader. I love to read, and I just read a great book, and I've like read passages to my friends.
I like that.
Because I think that, you know, reading is something that can bring great
and
joy.
And what you think about, you bring about, right? So you're reading positive things.
And the book is called The Bright Hour.
The Bright Hour. See? There you
Tammy
go.
Tammy asked.
Well, speaking of Tammy. Speaking of Jenna and Savannah exercising, boom, 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 boom. This is supposed to make you happy.
Yeah, you know, meditation, prayer correlates with happiness. And so, exactly. Yoga, meditation, prayer, they all correlate with happiness, as does exercise. That all brings about good, solid, positive thinking.
And here's the thing, though, you have to use them, right? You have to use them. Exercise gives us all kinds of great biochemicals, serotonin, dopamine. It helps us feel happier.
You know, I think it's so true that when you're stressed, the thing you want to do is open a bottle of wine or eat, you know, comfort eat. But the thing that makes you feel better, and Savannah and I had this yesterday, we did not want to work out, but I felt so much better after I got to the gym.
You never regret it.
Okay, finally, a file cabinet.
This really surprised me. Just getting organized and eliminating clutter.
Yes.
Over 300% more likely to be happy over those who have clutter in their lives.
Yes. These are all things we can do today.
And by the way, hasn't Oprah said this for 1,000 years?
I know, clutter costs money.
All right, thank you guys.
Thank you.